Welcome to me looking for better items for my Oculus Quest 2. Not 4, 2. Okay, so what this video is going to be and what it really is me trying to find items that I can either attach to or add on to my Quest 2 to make it more of a immersive experience and improve on what I already have. Now, the goal I'm trying to do is one, I want my entire Quest to fit in this tiny box. This was the case my brother got me for Christmas. It is the smallest case that he could find on Amazon or whatever site he went to. Most people have the bigger cases or the official one from Oculus. I wanted something that was compact and easy to move around. So, what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna see if I can replace what I have going on here with items on Amazon. And I have been searching like crazy for straps. Like, they've got a bunch of leather alternatives and everything. And I was like, let me go back to the roots of Oculus. Let me go back to the beginning of when I first got it and retry the strap that came with it with an attachment on there to see how that works. So, I've also even considered the idea of redoing the face mask and everything because I play a lot of Beat Saber. And when you play Beat Saber or any game that exercises you a lot, you sweat and you drench in sweat. It is the worst thing ever. So I thought, is there a face mask that I could find that would maybe eliminate the possibility of the sweat dripping down your face or going into your headset? Because that is like the most annoying thing. The whole point I'm trying to accomplish is one, I want to absorb that sweat or capture it and get rid of it in some way. And that's kind of what I'm doing with my quest right now. If I can get the freaking. Why? This thing is so huge. Like, already. Okay, so what I've done is I got microfiber cloth that I cut and I put it right here on the top, above where the lenses are, on the headrest. And my face meshes against it, so when I sweat, it absorbs it. And I can take it off and replace it and wash it. So that's what I've been doing. And I thought there has to be a better alternative because one, yeah, I'm getting my forehead, but I'm not getting the sides right here. And I've noticed when I sweat, my sweat will go around my eye and then go into the headset somehow because I wear glasses. It goes in there and it drenches around the side, it goes down my cheek, and oh my God, it is so irritating when you're playing a game. Enough with me complaining about me sweating. I've actually got a couple of options, and I'm trying to do this as cheap as possible. And I actually found a sweat absorbent cover, which is kind of redundant considering the spongy material they give you on the headset to start with, which is actually still on here. I still have it underneath, but right now I have a silicone cover over here, mainly because the silicone's great. I'm not complaining about that. When you play it for a long period of time, like I do, like on VR chat, that's where it starts to become an issue because you get sweat right here, you get sweat around the sides, on your forehead, and what does sweat do when it's pressed against some area and it's like really hot and warm and humid? It starts to smell. So I'm trying to eliminate that. I want to take better care. Oh, surprisingly, I'm one of the few people that don't actually develop acne or anything from doing VR because of that, but I'm surprised. I don't know about my other friends. I'll have to ask them because I know they've got the default stuff, but I'm going to end up buying these. And I've got a few other things, but we'll get to those in a moment. I want to try this mask first. It looks like it just kind of sits over the default the default thing that's built on. So, oh, they even got the glasses spacer in there. And it looks like it just kind of hooks around the sides. But I'm gonna get this. The next option I'm going to get to extend my playtime is this battery that you can plug to the headset, which will basically. There was another YouTuber that I was actually looking up videos on finding stuff for making everything to last a while. And believe it or not, I actually found this dude's channel called Oculus Quest Play. And he made a video called the NIVRANA. I can't even pronounce it right. The NIVRANA. I'm not sure what to say that because they normally have the VR capitalized. I don't know why they didn't do it on here, but he made a video on it. And if I hadn't have found his video, I wouldn't have given it a chance because he's been using it and he says it does very well. And he's said it increases the playtime up to 10 hours, but they have it listed as 8. I'm guessing that's because, maybe because that's the default amount of hours just for the power pack that it comes with. So you get the pouch, the battery, and the cable, which I can't complain. But on here, they're showing a default strap as well as another type of strap. That's the elite strap, I believe, which is kind of redundant. But is there an elite strap and an elite charging strap? Because if there's two different ones, but it looks identical, Oculus, why? Is it for those people that want to get the elite strap, but then you have the incentive to make people buy the other version because you got a built-in battery? Because I've looked it up. I can't justify myself buying a $100 elite strap when it's not going to give me the playtime I want. That's the whole point and why I wanted to get this. But aside from the power pack and the face mask, we're going to go to the extra padding. That's what I'm getting at. So my idea is I'm going to get this padding to put onto the strap here for the default one. I'm going to switch it back over. And this power pack should fit over in a fashion where it's got the two buttons and it just wraps around. So my logic here is it should be able to button between these two marks right here. It might work. I don't know. I'm gonna give it a try. My plan isn't really 100% foolproof here, but it's gonna be a more of an, oh, I see two extra button right there. Okay. So that keeps it from sliding down further. I'm hoping there's enough material in there to get this to work. But if not, I'll figure it out. The next option is number one, I'm gonna replace my grips on my controllers. And here's why. These grips are actually great. But here's the one flaw. I have big hands. Yes, they're Velcro. The Velcro works. It's the position on where they have it hooked together. And I hate this a lot because where it's connected, it keeps your controller oriented at a higher position than it is angled like it's supposed to be when you're actually supposed to hold it. So what's going on here is the strap is being forced to be bent upward. It should have been connected to this slot where the default thing was, but for some reason they put it on the bottom. And with this design, what I'm hoping is because the way they have it connected, it's got like an anchor movement that moves right there. And by doing that, I'm hoping it's actually going to adjust better to my hand. So I'm considering this as an upgrade. And two, this looks like a cover for the actual controller. I don't think it's a cover for the halo part, but I could be wrong. I won't know till I actually get it. It might be a clear one. It might not. I'm not sure. They don't have the logo on there or anything. Well, it is default. I don't see the logo. They might have photoshopped the logo out, but all it is just a silicone rubber seal that goes over it with a strap. But that strap actually looks nice because that one looks like it hooks better. And the brand name, Kiwi, I actually have their wire suspenders that you connect from the ceiling. But you know, parents, they don't want you to drill into the ceiling or anything, so I'm trying to be respectful. I'm like, okay, I'll find another way to do it. And it wasn't long because I have my cable running across the floor here. And then Oculus announced the Oculus Air Link. I've tried using a virtual desktop, it works great for when I'm not recording. But when I'm trying to record, virtual desktop's not very recorder or streamer friendly for that matter. Believe me, I tried to get that to work when I did my first live stream over at Myrtle Beach. When I took my entire setup over there, virtual desktop does not let you access your windows and all the stuff like the Oculus software does. And I like the Oculus software better because you can actually access your taskbar and your windows and everything like you're supposed to and hit your recording software and have multiple windows up, but virtual desktop only has like one desktop window at one time. You can't put multiple windows everywhere. And that's the part that kind of got me. It's like, virtual desktop's great if you want to play your games. That's what its main use is for. But it's not great for streamers or people who record videos like I'm doing. Then we've got the actual shopping cart, and oh my god, I'm about to spend $120 on all this. Wow. Oh goodness. I'm gonna have to make a part two for when this stuff gets here. About to choke on the price. That's what it is. I really tried to get this to be as cheap as I could. And what got me to make, I was at like $80, and then I had to add the VR cover because I was like, that's gonna be a nice addition. I want to try it out. I'll make an additional video. I'm really trying my best to make this a wireless experience and to be able to play in VR a longer time period than just the hour or two that the default battery gives you. Oculus, you made a great product, but you don't give us enough battery. And I think that's mainly due to the limit of the size of the device, because you can't put like a supersized battery in there. But everything else, you're doing great. But I think it has something to do with you gotta make it cheap for people to afford it. And here's the other downside is the ugly other side of it. I've bought the link cable, that's $80. Got the accessories I have now with it, I got for Christmas, so I can't say I paid for those. So I don't even know how much those cost because I got those for Christmas. I'm already investing another 120 on here. My Oculus was 400 when I got it. I'm already at like a $500 mark now. No, 500, maybe 80 or so. If you count virtual desktop included, that's 600 right there. Oh no. What am I doing? Oh no. I guess some of you are wondering, why don't you just get a Vive headset? No, I don't want a Vive headset, and here's why. I don't want to be tethered to a computer. I want to have a wireless experience, and I don't know of a headset that actually does it as this well. And me being my first Oculus headset, I've looked at other people that have the Vive, and they don't have all the tools and stuff that Oculus gives you with the software. So I feel like Oculus is giving you more when you go into it than you would with the HTC Vive because you don't have all the windows and stuff like you would with the Oculus software on the PC when you're in VR. And that's my whole argument. I just like being able to move all my windows around and everything else in VR. It's just really cool. Not to mention the hand tracking that comes with it. Now you can type with your keyboard. You can sit on your couch in VR. I don't really have a couch in here, but it's astonishing and it works. And then the Oculus Air Link, I've tested it. It's amazing. It's just like you're being plugged with a cable. So if I can just extend the battery life, I'll be great. If you guys even made it to the end of this video, I appreciate you like hell. Go ahead, like the button, like. The blah 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 blah. Hit the like button for me. I'm gonna make a part two when you get these items get here, and I'll show you guys what it's like and how it's working. Who is messaging me? Oh, my YouTube assistant. I will get back to you guys in the next video. So for now, I'm gonna say peace out, and we're gonna do a cut, and the next episode will be after this later on. Bye guys.